What's up, guys? It's Tom. Welcome back to another video. A few months back, I posted a video about how I set up my Yamaha NS-10M studio monitors. Got a lot of good feedback from that video, and one of the comments on that video asked, how do I even connect speakers like this to my audio interface? So today, that's what we're going to talk about. I'm going to show you guys exactly how to connect passive studio monitors to your audio interface. Most of the studio monitors that are made today are active studio monitors. And what does that mean? Basically, what it means is you plug in your cable, you turn on the power, and the speaker works. It's because the speaker has a power source built into it. Passive studio monitors are what they might sound like. There is no onboard power source. So to get sound from your computer through the interface to the speakers, you have to have an external power supply, or what one would call an amp. Now with an active speaker, you can use your kind of standard quarter-inch style TRS cable. But with passive studio monitors, you have to go back to the good old-fashioned speaker wire. So to make all this happen, here's what we're gonna need. We need our computer, our interface, we need our power amp, and then lastly, we need our speaker. First things first, let's connect our computer to our audio interface. Now for this video, I'm using the M-Audio Fast Track Pro. It's just a simple little interface that I had lying around. I'm not going to pull my main interface out of my rack. This will serve our purposes just fine. We're going to connect the computer to the audio interface, make sure we're getting sound, and then from there, we need to connect the audio interface to our power amp. Now there are a couple ways you can do this. One is to just take this speaker wire and plug it directly into the back of the amp and then plug it directly into the back of the speaker. But there is a little thing that can make your life a lot easier, and it's called a banana plug. And it looks like this. Basically, what happens with a banana plug is you can thread the speaker wire into either side of the plug. You have a stereo connection, and then you can just plug that into the back of your power amp. It makes your life a lot easier than it would be if you were back there unscrewing the little things trying to plug in your speaker wire. That's a huge pain. You don't have time for that. Now that we've connected the speaker wire to the amp, it's time to connect it to the speaker. Now, what I like to do to make sure that I have the right connections is before I plug anything in, I make a little black mark on the corresponding ends of the speaker cable. That way I know which one's positive and which one's negative. I can make sure I don't switch those signals from the amp to the speaker. Pretty self-explanatory. There's black and red on the back of the amp, and there's black and red on the back of the speaker. Just plug the correct ones into the correct sides, and you're good to go. And just like that, now that everything is connected, it's time to hit play. That is how you connect a passive studio monitor to your interface. One additional step from active, it's worth it. These old school speakers sound great. I love my NS10s. My mixes have gotten loads better since I started using them. If you want to give them a shot, this is how you hook them up. Hit me in the comments. Let me know if there's something else you want me to distill down that you want to learn. As always, thank you for watching. I hope this video helps, and I'll catch you on the next one. Peace. Thank you.